Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will cover ISRO Technical Assistant 2016 paper. Exam was conducted by BSSC Trivandrum. Question 1. The pair of physical quantities having the same unit, thrust and weight. Thrust unit is Newton and weight unit is also Newton, so A is your correct answer. Here thrust unit is Newton, pressure unit is Newton per mm square or megapascal or bar also they are writing. So B not possible. C, force unit is Newton, pressure unit is Newton per mm square or megapascal. C not possible. Weight and pressure Newton, weight unit is Newton. Then pressure unit is Newton per mm square. So D also not possible. A is your correct answer. Question is, a wheel of diameter 10 cm describes 600 revolutions per minute. The angular velocity of the wheel is how much? So wheel is like this. Its diameter is 10 cm. The angular velocity, we know velocity is distance divided by time, or angular velocity radian, how much radian it covered divided by time. It's radian divided by time, angular velocity, or omega theta divided by time. So here, for one complete revolution, theta is 2 pi radian it's moving. For n revolution, total distance is 2 pi into n. So our angular velocity, you will get angular velocity in n revolution, it's 2 pi n divided by your time. Or you can write it as 2 pi n radian per second. Unit time if you will take 1 second. If you are taking second, then 2 pi n also, n normally they are giving in RPM. So you have to convert this one into RPS. 2 pi n by 60. It's in radian per second. So here in this question, revolution per minute given. If they will give in revolution per second term, then no need to divide 60. You can write just 2 pi n. You will get your answer. But here they gave in revolution per minute term. So n equal to 600 RPM. Its revolution per second, omega equal to 2 pi radian moving in one complete revolution. So n complete revolution, n is 60 divided by per in radian per second, we have to calculate. So 60, here you will get 20 pi radian per second. From option A is your correct answer. The designation of sheet size given 594 into 841, and we know for A1 sheet its width width into height is, width is 594 mm and their height is 841 mm. For A2 it's 420 into 594. Then for A3 size paper it's 297 into 420. Unit is mm, and for A4 size paper it's 210 into 297 mm. So here in this question they ask for 594 into A1, 841, it's in mm, A1 size paper, 594 into 841 mm, A1 size paper. This question is from engineering drawing. Which of the following is the lightest pencil? So for pencil, H stands for hard lead and lighter in shade, and B stands for soft lead, darker shade, or B stands for black. So here in this question, lightest pencil, H is the lightest. And if they will ask for darker pencil, darker or more black is 2B. 2B is having highest black. And HB, it's medium. In 2B case, the lines, they will become more dark. Like this, they will come in 2B case. And B case, it's less dark. And your HB case, it's mixture of dark and your light. H case, it will come as thin line. If you check the width also, highest width you will get in 2B case. Lowest width or lightest pencil is H pencil. From this option, if you increase towards 8, then you will get more lighter, and if you want darker, then you have to go towards B side. Question is, the neutral axis of the cross section of a beam is that axis at which the bending stress is neutral axis. We know bending stress formula, sigma by y equal to m by i. So sigma b here, bending stress, sigma b equal to m into y by I, y is the distance from your neutral axis. So the neutral axis, at neutral axis y equal to 0. If y will become 0, means your sigma b or bending stress, it will become 0. So from option, bending stress is 0. A is your correct answer. Question is, this question is from thermal stress or temperature stress. A steel bar of 6 mm is heated from 25 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius. It's free to expand. This is your key word. It's free to expand means no stress will come. The bar will induce no stress. A is your correct answer. The stress strain relationship of a Newtonian fluid. I think this question they asked in 2015 paper also. Question is repeating. So your Newtonian fluid, stress versus strain rate, or d theta by dt. For Newtonian fluid, it's linear. This is for Newtonian fluid. This is for Newtonian fluid. If you check the option, Newtonian fluid, linear. A is your correct answer. Question is, Francis turbine is best suited for medium head application for, yes, Francis turbine is for medium head application from 24 meter to 180 meter. A is your correct answer. And for low head installation, this is for Kaplan turbine. Then for high head, they are using your Pelton wheel or your impulse turbine. And Francis turbine, it's a mixed flow turbine. It's used for medium head application, or specific speed also medium. It's a reaction turbine. And for modern Francis turbine, its inlet is radial and axial, outlet is axial, opposite of your centrifugal pump. In case of centrifugal pump, your inlet is axial and outlet is radial. Match the following, least one and least two matching. We know in case of annealing, we are doing furnace cooling, slowest cooling rate. It improves ductility. And for nitriding, it's a surface hardening process. Then you are using nitriding for low carbon steel, and normalizing, it's air cooling. Cooling rate is little bit faster than annealing. Annealing we are using furnace cooling, and normalizing we are using air cooling. and normalizing, it refines grain structure. And for mar tempering is an interrupted quenching process. Inter mar tempering, it improves hardness of the whole mass. So A with improved ductility, A with triple I, so you can cut A and D, A with triple I. Then nitriding, it's a surface hardness, so increases surface hardness. B with IV, here also B with IV. Then normalizing refines grain structure, C with 1, here C with 2. So you can cut C, B is your correct answer. Then mar tempering, interrupted quenching process, D with double I, improves hardness of whole mass. Mar tempering and os tempering, both are interrupted quenching processes. And we know while quenching it's a faster cooling process or very fast cooling process. That time during cooling, more stress will develop and distortion and cracking tendency also occurs. So that's why you are using mar tempering or interrupted quenching, so that your stress will minimize and your tendency of distortion and cracking both will reduce. So this is the end of this part. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.